I'm glad to talk at LDAPCon again. Thank you. Today, I'll talk about using LDAP for FIDO2 authentication. These are FIDO authenticators I'm testing. SoloKey is my favorite one because the SoloKey can be modified firmware and open sourced. You don't need to buy these authenticators unless you are a FIDO collector. You already have FIDO authenticator if you have an Android phone. Also, Apple announced they will support FIDO2 for Mac OS. A day before the LDAPCon, I climbed the Bitosha Mountain. Do you know? Yes, you can see that mountain. Yes. The top of the mountain in the thick fog like rain. I couldn't see anything and very cold. At this time, I had all authenticator in my pocket. So I was dripping wet, so I was worried about my authenticator were broken. But they are fine. I've confirmed my authenticators are waterproof. Okay. I just classified several types for FIDO authentication flow. First one is two-factor with password authentication. Password authentication, then FIDO authentication, or using FIDO, then input password. Either one is fine. But personally, I hate this flow looking from the user side. The user gets additional overhead and the user experience gets worse. Next one is single factor and passwordless flow. This flow just proves the user presence to touch the authenticator such as YubiKey. It means only to prove position of the authenticator. Third one is multi-factor and passwordless flow. The recent authenticator supports the user verify feature. The user verify means local authentication such as inputting PIN or using biometrics. Lastly, I'd like to kill username too. Several authenticators has a region to store user ID. This region called resident key. Actually, the user ID does not mean username. I'll explain later. The client sends two types of requests, registration and authentication. The authenticator creates key pair at registration time and mapping to user entity and credential entity. Then the user to be able to authenticate with FIDO authenticator. This is the directory structure for FIDO2 credentials. A user may use multiple authenticator, so user entity and credential entity is one too many relationship. Now the user entry will be stored in user's directory, and the credential entity will be stored in credential directory. This is the LDAP schema for storing FIDO2 credentials. I'll describe each attribute. I'd like to make generic schema, so I welcome your review and improvement. The FIDO2 credential ID attribute is used to store credential ID that is a unique identifier linked to public key. Note that public credential ID is actually stored on authenticator as a byte string. This attribute is part of DN, so I encode it with base64 URL to make easy command line operation. The real credential ID is stored in FIDO, Find to row ID attribute with binary syntax. Next attribute is find to sign count. The authenticator has a counter that is incremented for each authentication. The relying party is able to detect cloned authenticator by comparing the counter. Note that the feature is only detect cloned authenticator, not to prevent authentication with cloned authenticator. The find to public key attribute is used to store public key that was created by authenticator. The public key is stored in Koji key format. Why do you use Koji key format instead of traditional PKCS1 format? So Koji key format is new public key representation. It is designed to be smaller than the traditional key format. This is a summary. I confirmed the how small Koji key. Certainly, Koji key is smaller than other formats. Next attribute is AAGUID is an identifier that indicates model of authenticator. The authenticator will only send AAGUID when using attestation. Otherwise, AAGUID is padded with 0 byte. Lastly, the find-to-user-id attribute is used to store user.id, also called as user handle in Web OAuth specification. The user.id is easy to make confuse in file. What is user.id? The user.id, also known as user handle, is a byte string identifier that is too mapped to credential entity and user entity. And also, WebAuth specs says user.id don't include username or email addresses. The find to user ID attribute should be generated as a unique random identifier and also be added to user entry when first credential registration. And also the find to user ID attribute in these entry must be kept consistency. This is difficult to LDAP because LDAP has no transaction. I decided to use entry UUID for user.id. Entry UUID is operational attribute that is defined RFC 4530. UUID is generally represented as text string, but it is actually 16-byte array. The entry UUID is a persistent ID linked with the user entry. It seems to be suitable for WebAuthn user.id. Okay, I'll show you demonstration. If you have authenticator or Android phone, you can try yourself by accessing the URL. I'll show you two types of demonstration. First one is passwordless authentication, and second one is usernameless authentication. At first, I just log in with username and password. You can log in with guest and guest. Okay, this is showing just only user entry and already registered credentials. Now, I push register credentials. Ah, sorry, I'm not connected by the device. I'm trying to Phaeton bypass authenticator. And touching. Okay, succeed to register credential. Maybe this one. So this is mapped to credential entry, just a LDAP entry. So then log out. And just inputting username and press login button. Now pop ups the browser succeed passwordless authentication. Next one is usernameless registration. Press register credential with resident key. And then touching authenticator. So I'm wetting my finger, so demonstration will fail. So now you can see only login button. Just pushing login button, and then if you register multiple user on one authenticator, so listing a username. So now I'm using guest user. Okay, succeed. Okay, thank you for looking my demonstration. So now if you can try run the RP server, just type these command makes the RP server on your laptop. It just require Docker and Docker Compose. Thank you for attention.